Did you ever need to convert numbers like this into words, maybe for invoices or for checks? Or maybe you needed it the other way around, where you have the number spelled out and you need to put it as digits in another cell. Until now, you would do it manually, use macros maybe, or use crazy nested functions. But now you have another option. That's practically like just referencing these cells. You just need to put this inside Excel's new AI function, which is Copilot. So if you don't see Copilot yet, that's because it's rolling out and your company does need to have a Copilot license. Now, all we need to do is give it a prompt, which is inside quotes, and then give it the context, which is our cell references. Now, when it comes to your prompt, the more information you provide, the better. Now, I'm just going to tell it that these are prices in US dollars, convert each number into words in English, and let's see what we get. There we have it, $123,568. That's correct. This is $65.86. This last one is $6,902.20. So it understood that point two should be 20 cents, so it got the context. Just remember that this is AI generated, so you should check these for accuracy. Now, what you could actually also do is do it the other way around. So I'm going to use Copilot and give it a prompt, turn each spelled out number into digits and reference this. Now, I'm not sure if this is clear, but let's see what we get. So we have the same values returned. Now, that's pretty cool. Now, how about returning these in another language? So let's say I wanted to return these in German. That should work too. I'll just change these from US dollars to euro as well. Now let's see what we get. If you don't speak German, I think you're going to find this interesting. So this looks like it's just gibberish, but this is actually how it's written in German. This is 123,568. Yeah, you don't breathe while you read these. So these seem correct, but they're not being returned as currency because, first of all, I don't see euro anywhere here. And this one says comma zwei, and it should say 20 cent because it should be 20 cents. So I thought it was clear in my prompt, but the AI doesn't think I'm clear. So let's just do return as currency and see what we get. Now we have euro back here. This is 86 cents. That's 86 cent. And that last one looks correct. This is 6,902 euro and 20 cent. We can also see the returned values match our original values. Now, how about grabbing numbers from freeform text? So for example, here we have webinar comments, and sometimes people have mentioned a price. We want to grab that price. But the twist is that it's not always numbers. Sometimes they've written it out. In fact, in a lot of cases, they've written it out. Here they've said, I would be comfortable paying $120. Then here is 95. That's easy to spot. This one is also not easy to spot. We have to actually read this. So I think your tax consulting is worth about $150. Imagine you have a lot of cells and you need to go through this manually and do this, right? That's what we would be doing right now. But with the help of AI, this whole process can be a lot easier. All we need to do is start off with Copilot, give it a prompt. I'm going to tell it to give me the value mentioned in each comment. Sometimes it's in words and sometimes it's in digits. Let's put this in quotes and we're going to reference our cells. Close the bracket and let's see what we get. Instantly, we get the values returned. So this is 120, 95, the 150, here is 75. We have 75 returned. Sometimes they haven't mentioned anything. So here someone said, I wish it was free, and we return nothing. So this is super cool. But remember, we're still using AI here. So if it is important that each single number is 100% correct, you need to double check this, which means you have to go through each line and make sure the number is correct, which means that you might as well do this manually, right? So the AI can save you time if you are okay with the fact that there might be some mistakes here. This might be 80% accurate. If that's the case, go for it. Now, if you don't have the Copilot function and you're looking for a way of converting numbers into words, I made a video about this some years ago. I'm going to add the link in the description. Now, it would be really cool to see how many already have Copilot. So if your company already has Copilot or they're planning to roll out Copilot, just type yes in the comments. If you're not sure, you think that they might get it, put maybe, if not, put no. Because it would be really cool to see how many people will ultimately have access to this function that I just showed right now. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you for being here, and I'll catch you in the next video.